Who said that?
The lady at the store.
That is not a compliment.
The talk confronts some of these larger social questions of like, why don't I get this same opportunity that this person does? Some of the threads that we really wanted to be mindful of, it felt like they should all be motivated by some version of love, whether they all had like a different motivation where like one's like more cautious or one's more mad or one's more celebratory, one's more like questioning along with their child. It was important for us to kind of hit all the different emotional beats along the way with the stories. We really wanted this to go far in terms of anybody being able to access this conversation. I think it's important for us to have a safe space. We didn't want to push anyone away with this story. We more just wanted to create like an open space that felt universal, that's like, look deep into this aspect of our culture and now make up your own mind.
This is not about you getting a ticket. This is about you not coming home.
Talking about some of the lines that were more than what you would see in typical advertising, that could potentially be a little bit more inflammatory, like worrying about your son or your daughter coming home. Us being mindful of the tone really helped that. It was like the mother at that point was like just being very concerned for her daughter. Like, look, this is the reality that I'm actually talking about. This is the perspective. And her daughter's like, I'm gonna be okay, right? And it's more of a question that she gives her mother. So I think the execution allows it to be more digestible so that the line doesn't seem inflammatory. It was tailored for supporting the mothers that were talking to their children in this. And in that way, I feel like it was successful. And then also it's successful in a way of like allowing people to have their own experience with it, whether positive or negative. And that's ultimately what we wanted. That's why we called it The Talk.